Hi, my name is Shraddha Jaiswal and I'm a verbal expert at EG Math. Let us solve this difficult official question using the EG Math 3-step meaning-based approach. But before that, just a quick reminder. Do hit the like button below to let us know that you found this video helpful. That way, we at EG Math can keep creating such videos to help you and other students with their GMAT prep journey. So let's solve this question now. Now we will read this sentence and try to understand its meaning, as the meaning analysis is the very first step in our 3-step meaning-based approach. And we understand the meaning of the sentence by breaking it down into smaller chunks. The blue highlighted texts are the subjects and the green highlighted texts are the verb. So the sentence reads, in no other historical sighting did Halley's Comet cause such a worldwide sensation. So this part of the sentence says that Halley's Comet did not cause such a worldwide sensation in any other historical sighting. Then we read the last part, as did its return in 1910-1911. So surely we have a comparison here. The last part of the sentence completes that comparison by saying that Halley's Comet's return created a worldwide sensation in 1910 and 1911. So the comparison is actually between the action done by Halley's Comet and its return in 1911. Now, a lot of people find it very difficult to understand the exact meaning conveyed by this sentence, and that happens because of the complex structure of this sentence. This sentence uses what we call the inverted SV structure, where the verb appears before the subject. So let's simplify the structure of this sentence and write it in our general structure, which is subject first and then the verb. This is what our sentence will read. Halley's Comet did not cause such a worldwide sensation in any other historical sighting as its return did in 1910-1911. Now that we simplify the structure of the sentence, understanding the meaning of this sentence becomes so easy. And we can clearly see that this sentence presents the comparison between the actions done by Halley's Comet and its return in 1910-1911. And clearly, that this comparison is absolutely illogical, because we cannot compare the action of a comet with its return in any other period. So definitely we have the meaning issue in this sentence. Now that we understand the meaning of the sentence very, very clearly, let's move on to step number 2, which is error analysis, in which we will figure out various grammatical errors that might be present in this sentence. Very clearly, we know that this sentence has the meaning error, which is due to the comparison error, because in this sentence, the action of Halley's Comet has been compared with the action of its return, and this comparison is not logical. So this is the only error in this sentence. So through the answer choice analysis, we will find out which answer choice fixes this comparison error. But before doing that, if we think a little more, we can understand that the sentence should actually be presenting the comparison between Halley's Comet creating worldwide sensation in other historical sighting versus the worldwide sensation created by its return in 1910 and 1911. So basically, these two entities over here must be actually compared. The two sightings, other historical sightings and sighting in 1910-1911. These two entities must be compared. Now, with this deep understanding of the sentence, let us take a look at the answer choices. As we have already understood, choice A is incorrect because of the meaning error that comes by because of the comparison error that we have seen here. Choice B repeats the same comparison error because once again we see the verb had for the subject its return, had in 1910, 1911. But the usage of had introduces another error in this sentence. It breaks the parallelism because in the non-underlined portion, we have the verb did cause. So to keep it parallel, we need the verb did and not had. So choice B is wrong for these two reasons. Choice C is the correct answer here because it presents the intended meaning absolutely logically. It says, in no other historical sighting did Halley's Comet cause such a worldwide sensation as in its return of 1910-1911. The thing to note here is that Halley's Comet did. This subject verb is actually understood after as in choice C. Okay, so the comparison is still very clear even if this subject verb pair is understood or implied in choice C. Now the sentence correctly compares the two historical sighting, which is any other historical sighting, and the sighting in its return of 1910 and 1911. So we know that choice C presents the correct comparison and hence is the correct answer. Let's take a look at choice D. If you understood that there is a problem in choice A, you will right away reject choice D because all it does is that it changes the position of did in choice D. In choice A, this did appeared in the beginning of the choice. In choice D, it appears at the end of the choice. But the meaning conveyed by this choice is exactly the same as we get from choice A. It presents illogical comparison. So choice D is out. Choice E says its return in 1910-1911. Now here we have idiom expression. Why? Because as when it is used to present comparison, it must be followed by a clause or a prepositional phrase, as we see in case of choice C. But in choice E, we neither see a verb nor do we see any preposition. So now the structure that we have here is as plus noun, its return, right? So it is as plus noun. And when we use as plus noun, it actually presents the function of the noun that precedes as. So this sentence totally distorts the intended meaning of the sentence. The comparison is totally gone in the sentence. There is no comparison presented in this choice. And also now it says that in no other historical sighting did this comet cause such a worldwide sensation as its return in 1910, as if the worldwide sensation is the return in 1910-1911. So absolutely illogical meaning. Choice E is out. Now, the most interesting fact about this sentence is that maximum people end up choosing choice A. And that happens because, as I said, the complex, because people cannot really see what comparison this sentence presents because of the complex structure of the sentence. So whenever you see such a complex sentence where you see that the verb appears before the subject, try to simplify it and then see what's going on with the sentence. That way you will be able to clearly see or clearly understand the communicated meaning. So yes, as we found out, choice C is the correct answer. Hope you enjoyed solving this question with me. Thank you and happy learning.